Welcome to Widener News. I'm your host, Joanne Klein.
And I'm your co-host, Mykia Jones.
Are you interested in having a family on campus? September 28th through October 2nd is the beginning of Panhellenic Council's fall recruitment. The potential new members are welcome to join the sisters of Phi Sigma Sigma, Delta Phi Epsilon, and Sigma 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 at theme parties Monday through Wednesday at each of their houses for an hour. On Thursday will be preference night by invitation, and Friday is bid day. All potential new members going are encouraged to visit all three houses, and hopefully by the end of the week, they'll find the perfect place to call home.
Not only is this week recruitment for sororities, but fraternities as well. Keep an eye out around campus for each organization scheduled. If you have any questions about recruitment or Greek life in general, contact the Office of Student Life.
Don't want to join Greek life and want to help out with their philanthropies? You can never go wrong with a nice, peaceful game of wiffle ball. This Saturday, Theta Chi is hosting its first annual wiffle ball tournament on Memorial Field. You can gather some of your friends and start a team for $25 or pay $5 and be put on a team. The event starts at 12 o'clock and goes until 5 p.m. with food and drinks provided. All proceeds and donations go to the Suicide Awareness Organization. Contact Joe Racine for more information.
Let's check in with Matt Nissenfeld and see how our own sports teams are doing.
The Widener men's soccer team got a nice win over Gwinnett Mercy on September 19th, securing their third win of the season. The Pride won 1-0 in what was an exciting contest. Scoring for the Pride was senior forward Eric Taylor. Taylor chipped a beautiful shot over the Gwinnett keeper early on in the match to give the Pride the lead. Another standout for the Pride was junior goalkeeper Jonathan Rouse, who recorded a clean sheet. The Pride will take on FDU Florham on the 26th. Shockingly, the women's soccer team won 1-0 as well on the 19th as they hosted the Bryn Mawr Owls. Freshman Gabrielle Campbell scored with just under 10 minutes left as she hammered home a throw-in from Brooke Palmieri. And just like her male counterpart, goalie Olivia Fouts got the shutout. Olivia also made a huge late-game save to preserve the 1-0 lead. The Pride will host Lebanon Valley on October 3rd.
And a huge congrats to both soccer teams.
I bet all those Ultimate Frisbee lovers were taking advantage of one specific Glow Week activity last week. Last Wednesday, they had a Spin Art Frisbee event where students were able to custom paint their own Frisbees with neon and glow-in-the-dark colors. The event was free and loads of fun for Widener students. I bet we'll be seeing them around campus on Memorial Field.
Speaking of Glow Week, on September 26th, Pride Activities Council had a casino night. Let's check in and see how it all went.
We should shine a light on, a light on, and a book of right on, right on, it was right on.
It looks like the students had a great time, and I heard there were a lot of awesome prizes.
Will you be voting for our country's next leader? Well, not without being registered. If you missed the National Voter Registration Day last week, Political Awareness Club has you covered. This Tuesday, they'll be hosting a voter registration event as well. This event will be held in the Pride Cafe in University Center at 12. Don't forget to sign up in order to be eligible to vote in the coming elections. Every vote counts.
Enough about those elections. They're months away. Let's talk about SGA. Students have campaigned and the new senators have been chosen. Tuesday, the newly elected senators will officially be sworn into the office of the UC in the web room. Congratulations to all the new senators.
Well, if politics isn't your thing, how about writing? Widener University will partner with the Media Arts Council for the second season of the State Street Reading Series this fall. Local authors from around the area will be sharing excerpts of their work. Widener's own Dr. Michael Cacharel and Associate Harvard Professor Dr. Asali Solomon will kick off the event September 17th from 7 to 9 p.m. in the Media Arts Center Gallery. This is a great way to network, build your resume, and best of all, it's free to attend.
Do you have any professional clothing that you don't wear anymore? The English department is running a women's career wear business and professional attire clothing drive throughout the month of September. The clothing will go to the women's mentor groups in Chester, young women entering the workforce, and other women re-entering societies post-incarceration. If you care to help out and donate, they are looking for business clothing in good condition, and they can be dropped off in the Old Main and University Center and the Quick Center.
As we mentioned before, it is Hispanic Heritage Month. In celebration, Pride Night is back with Trivia Night with Latinos Unidos. Come this Friday night to participate and answer questions about Latinos Unidos. Maybe even win a prize. It's free, but do not forget your Widener student ID and install the Involvio app on your phone to get in. Well, that's it for today. Bringing you the latest news on events, updates, and student involvement. Widener News is here for you. I'm your host, Joanne Klein.
And I'm your co-host, Mykia Jones. Thank you for tuning in and see you next time.